misteryo, mas kaysa kanyarihan ng Espiritu Santo.
We begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate one of the solemnities of the Lord during these days of the ordinary time. The solemnity of the Most Blessed Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We make this day a special day to praise their wondrous deeds done in our lives, their presence in our lives, and how they keep on loving us till the end. So as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us humbly acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for His pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Excelsis Deo.
Oh,
kapangyarihan sa lahat. Panginoong Yesu Kristo, Pugtong na Anak, Panginoong Diyos, Kordero ng Diyos,
let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Ask now of the days of old, before your time, ever since God created man upon the earth. Ask from one end of the sky to the other. Did anything so great ever happen before? Was it ever heard of? Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire, as you did, and live? Or did any God venture to go and take a nation for himself from the midst of another nation by testings, by signs and wonders, by war, by strong hand and outstretched arm, and by great terrors? All of which the Lord your God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes. This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God in heavens above and on earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep his statutes and commandments that I enjoin on you today, that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may have long life on the land which the Lord your God is giving you forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made. By the breath of his mouth, all their host. For he spoke, and it was made. He commanded, and it stood forth. The eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you.
Blessed are we, O Lord, our soul set to be.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption, through whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if only we suffer with Him, so that we may also be glorified with Him. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they all saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. We would like to greet all of you a blessed feast of the Most Holy Trinity. And as I've said, that this is one of the feasts of the Lord during these days that we are already in the ordinary time. Sa susunod po na linggo, ang atin naman pong ipagdiriwang ay yung kapistahan ng banal na katawan at dugo ng ating Panginoon. And our celebration today of the solemnity of the Most Blessed Trinity of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is not just placed by the Church, or was not just placed by the Church for the sake na may maipagdiwang tayo sa mga araw na ito or for any other reason. No? Parang wala lang. Sige lang, lagay tayo ng piyesta, no? Para meron naman tayong piyestang maipagdiriwang. No? Ipinagdiriwang po natin yung mga buhay ng mga santo. And almost every day, there are feasts of the saints. We may know it or not. We celebrate the feasts of our places, ng ating mga simbahan, at kung saan man po tayo naroroon. Pero sa araw na pong ito, kahit ba na sana, linggo-linggo, araw-araw, o oras-oras, ay inaalala at pinupuri natin ang Diyos. Today, we hopefully give deeper emphasis, great reverence, and remind ourselves of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in our lives. Naririto po tayo sa misang ito para ipaalala sa atin ang madalas na marahil nakakalimutan na nating katotohanan, may Diyos. May Diyos. Baka lang po nakakalimutan natin, may Diyos. Kung ano-ano pong ginagawa natin, paalala lang, may Diyos. Baka akala po natin nag-iisa lang tayo sa laban sa buhay, paalala lang muli, may Diyos. Narito po tayo para hindi lang ipaalala sa akin o ipaalala sa inyo, may Diyos po tayo. And our readings today would like us to open our eyes to this sometimes forgettable fact. Moses was reminding the people, yung Diyos na kasama ninyo sa buhay ninyo, God Himself carried you, God freed you, God saved you. Nagwika ang Panginoon sa inyo, nakasama ninyo ang Panginoon sa buhay ninyo. May Diyos. St. Paul would tell us in our second reading that there is God because we are not thrown into nowhere, but because there is God, we are being claimed by a loving God. Isang Diyos na ginagawa tayong kasapi ng buhay natin, ng buhay niya. In our gospel, we've heard the commissioning story of the apostles according to Mark. May Diyos na pangako si Jesus. May Diyos na kinakailangang itatak ang mga alagad sa bawat isa. May Diyos na ipinangako si Jesus na hanggang sa dulo ng daigdig, kasama natin. May Diyos na kasama nila noon. May Diyos na umiibig. May Diyos na hanggang ngayon ay kapiling. Muling paalala, may Diyos. More than for the church to celebrate, this feast is for all of us. Para po sa atin itong kapistahan na ito. Hindi lang para papurihan natin ang Diyos ng mas malalim sa araw na ito. Baka hindi lang din para seryosohin natin ang pagdadasal ng glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. But for us again to remind ourselves, there is God. Na hindi lang po nakulong ang Diyos o naiwan ng Diyos noong unang panahon. Hindi lamang po naroon ng Diyos nung masaya lang tayo. Hindi lang naroroon ng Diyos nung malakas tayo. Pero may Diyos noon, ngayong nagsisikap tayo at sa mga susunod na araw na haharapin natin ang buhay. There is God. God is here today and for the rest of our lives. Pero baka may magsasabi po sa atin, Father, ipinapaalala pala sa araw na ito na may Diyos. Pero bakit po ako naghihirap? Bakit po ako nabibigatan? Bakit po ako sinusubok? Bakit po parang kulang ako? Bakit po parang mabigat ang aking pakiramdam? May Diyos ba sa mga bagay na iyan, Aber? And I will answer you with a big yes. May Diyos na kasama mo para harapin iyan. May Diyos at may mga kaibigan kang nagwiwika para palakasin ang loob mo. May mga Diyos sa mga taong tumutulong sa iyo. May Diyos sa kalooban po natin, sa buhay po natin, para may lakas tayong harapin ang mga hinaharap natin sa buhay na ito. As I have said, this Sunday is also for us to remind ourselves. Alam po natin yung mga talino natin. Alam po natin yung mga abilidad at kapasidad po natin na ginagawa. May mga kanya-kanya po tayong talento rito. Kung tayo lamang ang magpapatakbo ng buhay natin sa mundong ito, mukha, no? Mukhang kaya po nating patakbuhin ang mga kanya-kanya po nating sistema. Kaya po nating pakilusin yung mga concerns, yung mga trabaho, yung mga iniisip po natin. Dahil may talino po tayo, may talento po tayo. Pero teka lang po, ano? Paalala lang muli, may Diyos. May Diyos pong sasala ng mga iniisip natin, mabuti man o hindi. May Diyos na magbibigay po sa atin ng sandamakmak na inspirasyon so that we can also share that inspiration to others. There is God who will be more than willing to help you plan, execute, and even embrace your life and maybe your plans. There is God who can help you and inspire you more and more. Baka magandang ipaalala rin po, hindi lang sa atin, kundi sa mga tao sa paligid natin, sa mga taong nais bumali sa mga utos ng Diyos. Paalala lang po, may Diyos. Alam ng Diyos anong iniisip natin. Alam ng Diyos anong binabalak natin. May Diyos para, sorry po, batukan tayo at sabihing, pinapaalala ko lamang, hindi ikaw ang nagpapatakbo ng buhay na ito, ako ang Diyos sa mundong ito. My dear brothers and sisters, like our readings today, and as I've said, this feast, every time that we cling too much to ourselves, o kaya minsang kalimutan na nating ang Diyos ay naroroon lamang noong mga unang panahon, and maybe forget what God can do, feel that God is a far away being, I would like you to do this simple everyday reminder and maybe prayer. Tap your shoulder. Tap your heart. Sabihin po ng maigi at mula sa puso. Kapag may haharapin, kapag may kailangan pagdesisyonan, kung kailangan tayong mapaalalahanan at mapalakas, may Diyos, may Diyos, may Diyos.
Please stand.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we are children of God. As true co-heirs with Christ, we can come to our Father with confident trust. And for every petition with faith we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church on earth may be drawn together to reflect the perfect unity of the Trinity, the community of divine love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who direct human society and frame our laws may submit to the commandments of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are slaves to fear may find the freedom of the sons and daughters of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through a new evangelization, we may bring non-believers to faith and baptism in our community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our departed brothers and sisters may be raised into the glory of the Holy Trinity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, we lift up to the Lord all of the prayers offered in this Mass, the prayers of our brothers and sisters joining us via online streaming. In communion, we also lift up to the Lord our prayers and support for all our brothers and sisters who are in discomfort now because of this weather that we are now experiencing. We lift up to the Lord our prayers for our nation and for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, as we offer our prayers, draw us into communion of the Spirit who dwells in your children, and the Son, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
The love of grace.
Please stand.
Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adorned in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek may find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so love the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart, joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death. And rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may the same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered people, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We would like to thank you once again, my dear brothers and sisters, for being with us this Sunday, and at least for braving the storm or the rain na bumaba po sa atin. Tunay nga pong may Diyos. Pinakinggan naman po tayo sa ating panalangin, and although this is both a gift and for some not a good gift for them, we pray and lend our hand to support them in this time of a little bit of a discomfort. Kaya po maraming salamat po sa inyo ring pagparito, and we hope and pray that God may continue to hear and bless you in your own prayers. Palakpakan po natin at papurihan po natin ang Panginoon. We also give thanks to God for the gift of our Manila Cathedral staff and servants for being the presence of God in our lives as we celebrate the Eucharist. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. I just don't know if Monsignor Rolly already announced it. By next Sunday, it will be the solemnity of the Most Holy Body and Blood of our Lord. And there will be this archdiocesan, well, it's an annual archdiocesan Corpus Christi celebration, and a holy mass will begin at the Archdiocesan Shrine of the Blessed Sacrament at Santa Cruz, Manila. And it will be at 3 p.m. to be presided by our Archbishop Jose Advincola. And after the Mass, the Blessed Sacrament will be processed from Santa Cruz going here at the Manila Cathedral for the final blessing with the benediction of the Blessed Sacrament. And after that, we shall begin the 6 p.m. Eucharistic celebration to be presided by our Rector, Monsignor Rolly. Kaya po sa inyong lahat, may we all invite you to join this celebration of the Corpus Christi. Let us pray for a very fine weather so that we can have that feel of journeying not only with saints carved in wood or in other materials, but let us also process with the presence of the Lord in the Most Blessed Sacrament. It will be this coming Sunday, June 2. And kindly mark your dates, no? We shall open the Manila Cathedral again for our annual open house this coming June 12. Kaya po, hintay-hintay nyo na lang din po ang aming mga announcements para po sa araw na ito. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May the Lord bless you and keep you forever and ever.
Amen.
May He let His face shine upon you and be gracious to you forever and ever.
Amen.
May He turn His countenance towards you and give you His peace forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.